My name is Mustafa Boswai, and I hail from East Jerusalem. Really, my family lived through for centuries on the slopes of Mount Olives, halfway between, you know, the mountain itself and the Silwan Pool. I teach at Al-Quds University. I'm Imam Al-Ghazali Chair of Islamic Studies at Al-Aqsa Mosque and Al-Quds University. I'm also the Dean of the Islamic Colleges at the University. There's a beautiful tradition of the Prophet, and I have been really fascinated and have been over many, many years, in fact for a long time. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said that if the Day of Judgment unfolds before your eyes and you have a seedling in your hand, you will basically, you are invited here. I mean, if you think about the scenario as following, things, the universe is being disrupted. Mm-hmm. The universe is being disrupted. And people, it's a moment that really, it's a moment of shock, of awe. People usually don't tend to anything when you have what you might consider like a disaster, a catastrophe. Mm-hmm. Nevertheless, the Prophet said, if that really is the moment, and this is the end of life, Day of Judgment means end of life, the Prophet said, and you have a seedling that you were about to plant, the Prophet said, go ahead and plant it. Mm. And this means that you do basically do that beautiful act of, you know, we talk about sustainability. This hadith encourages people to be proactive. If it's not really the Day of Judgment, it means one could also plant trees and what have you until his or her own end of life. Mm-hmm. So people should try to do their best in planting. And we do this, we try to do this, I try to do this mm-hmm. as much as possible. The Quran really refers to nature, really the cosmos, as incorporating signs that point in the direction of God. Mm-hmm. So practically everything in the universe points in the direction of God. One has only to be to be sensitive enough to realize that every single thing in the universe does point in the direction of God. Mm-hmm. And as such, one needs to make sure that we don't destroy the environment, otherwise we will be destroying these signs. So theologically, there are signifiers in the universe, in the environment, and by taking care of these signifiers, of these signs, we are really doing the right thing in terms of our relationship with God. In more simple terms, you know very well, for example, that in the United States there are problems. We as humanity created problems for bees. Mm-hmm. And of course, those specialists who try to understand what's going on, they said things like, for example, pesticides disorient the bees. Of course, the way we deal also with, you know, in terms of agriculture, mass production, it destroyed the flowers and what have you. And when I basically, and it takes basically bees to create basically like a pound of honey, they need to visit about 2 million flowers. Mm-hmm. And the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, taught us that if you plant a tree, fruit tree, whoever eats from that tree is a good deed for the person who planted this. So in terms of theologically, hereafter, it's a good deed. So if a bird comes and basically eats from that, from the fruit, then you are harvesting not the fruit itself, but you are harvesting good deeds. Mm. And here we talk about a beautiful concept. Now later on, after basically I became aware of the problem of the bees, of what have you, when I see bees in our garden, really visiting all these flowers that we have, theologically, deep in my heart, I think that here I am, you know, reaping the spiritual fruit of planting more and more flowers, taking into consideration that really I'm helping, even in a very small way, helping the bees, not in the United States, but even here, trying to create an environment that is hospitable, not only for us, but also for very small creatures.
Yeah. Mm.